Grand Guignol, Le Théâtre du Grand Guignol, the theater of the great puppet, dash known as the Grand Guignol, was a theater in the Pigalle area of Paris, at 20 bis. From its opening in 1897 until its closing in 1962, it specialized in naturalistic horror shows. Its name is often used as a general term for graphic, amoral horror entertainment, a genre popular from Elizabethan and Jacobean theater, for instance Shakespeare's Titus Andronicus, and Webster's The Duchess of Malfi and the White Devil, to today's splatter films. Le Théâtre du Grand Guignol was founded in 1894 by Oscar Métinier, who planned it as a space for naturalist performance. With 293 seats, the venue was the smallest in Paris. A former chapel, the theater's previous life was evident in the boxes, which looked like confessionals, and in the angels over the orchestra. Although the architecture created frustrating obstacles, the design that was initially a predicament ultimately became beneficial to the marketing of the theater. The opaque furniture and Gothic structures placed sporadically on the walls of the building exude a feeling of eeriness from the moment of entrance. People came to this theater for an experience, not only to see a show. The audience at Le Théâtre du Grand Guignol endured the terror of the shows because they wanted to be filled with strong feelings of something. Many attended the shows to get a feeling of arousal. Underneath the balcony were boxes, originally built for nuns to watch church services, that were available for theatergoers to rent during performances because they would get so aroused by the action happening on stage. It has been said that audience members would get so boisterous in the boxes that actors would sometimes break character and yell something such as "Keep it down in there." Conversely, there were audience members who could not physically handle the brutality of the actions taking place on stage. Frequently, the special effects would be too realistic and often an audience member would faint or vomit during performances. The theater owed its name to Guignol, a traditional Lyonnais puppet character, joining political commentary with the style of Punch and Judy. The theater's peak was between World War I and World War II, when it was frequented by royalty and celebrities in evening dress. Oscar Métinier was the Grand Guignol's founder and original director. Under his direction, the theater produced plays about a class of people who were not considered appropriate subjects in other venues: prostitutes, criminals, street urchins, and others at the lower end of Paris's social echelon. Max Maury served as director from 1898 to 1914. Maury shifted the theater's emphasis to the horror plays it would become famous for and judged the success of a performance by the number of patrons who passed out from shock. The average was two faintings each evening. Maury discovered André Delorde, who would become the most important playwright for the theater. Delorde was the theater's principal playwright from 1901 to 1926. He wrote at least 100 plays for the Grand Guignol and collaborated with experimental psychologist Alfred Binet to create plays about insanity, one of the theater's favorite and frequently recurring themes. Camille Choisy served as director from 1914 to 1930. He contributed his expertise in special effects and scenery to the theater's distinctive style. Jacques Jouvin served as director from 1930 to 1937. He shifted the theater's subject matter, focusing performances not on gory horror but psychological drama. Under his leadership, the theater's popularity waned and, after World War II, it was not well attended. Charles Nonin was the theater's last director. At the Grand Guignol, patrons would see five or six plays, all in a style that attempted to be brutally true to the theater's naturalistic ideals. The plays were in a variety of styles, but the most popular and best known were the horror plays, featuring a distinctly bleak worldview as well as notably gory special effects in their notoriously bloody climaxes. The horrors depicted at Grand Guignol were generally not supernatural. These plays often explored altered states, like insanity, hypnosis, or panic, under which uncontrolled horror could happen. To heighten the effect, the horror plays were often alternated with comedies. Le Laboratoire des Hallucinations, by André Delorde. When a doctor finds his wife's lover in his operating room, he performs a graphic brain surgery, rendering the adulterer a hallucinating semi-zombie. Now insane, the lover-slash-patient hammers a chisel into the doctor's brain. Un crime dans une maison de fou, by André Delorde. Two hags in an insane asylum use scissors to blind a pretty young fellow inmate out of jealousy. La Horrible Passion, by André Delorde. A nanny strangles the children in her care. Le Baiser dans la nuit, by Maurice Level. A young woman visits the man whose face she horribly disfigured with acid, where he obtains his revenge. Audiences waned in the years following World War II, and the Grand Guignol closed its doors in 1962. Management attributed the closure in part to the fact that the theater's faux horrors had been eclipsed by the actual events of the Holocaust 2 decades earlier. "We could never equal Buchenwald," said its final director, Charles Nonnen. "Before the war, everyone felt that what was happening on stage was impossible. Now we know that these things, and worse, are possible in reality." The Grand Guignol building still exists. It is occupied by a company devoted to presenting plays in sign language. Grand Guignol flourished briefly in London in the early 1920s under the direction of José Levy, where it attracted the talents of Sybil Thorndike and Noel Coward, and a series of short English Grand Guignol films, using original screenplays, not play adaptations, was made at the same time, directed by Fred Paul. Several of the films exist at the BFI National Archive. The Grand Guignol was revived once again in London in 1945, under the direction of Frederick Whitney, where it ran for 2 seasons at the Granville Theatre. These included premieres of Whitney's own work as well as adaptations of French originals. In recent years, English director-writer Richard Mazda has reintroduced New York audiences to the Grand Guignol. His acting troupe, the Queen's Players, have produced 6 main stage productions of Grand Guignol plays, and Mazda is writing new plays in the classic Guignol style. The 6th production, Theatre of Fear, included Delord's famous adaptation of Poe's The System of Dr. Tarr and Professor Feather, Le Système du Dr. Gaudron et P.R. Plume, as well as 2 original plays, Devil Crossed and The Good Death, alongside The Telltale Heart. The 1963 Mondo film Echo includes a scene which may have been filmed at the Grand Guignol Theater during its final years. American avant-garde composer John Zorn released an album called Grand Guignol by Naked City in 1992, in a reference to the darker side of our existence which has always been with us and always will be. Washington, D.C.'s Molotov Theater Group, established in 2007, is dedicated to preserving and exploring the aesthetic of the Grand Guignol. They have entered 2 plays into the Capitol Fringe Festival in Washington, D.C. Their 2007 show, For Boston, won Best Comedy, and their 2nd show, The Sticking Place, won Best Overall in 2008. The Swiss theater company, Compagnie Pie de Bicherie, visits the Grand Guignol genre in contemporary context since 2008. The company staged in 2010 a diptych Impact and Dr. Incubi's, based on original texts by Nicholas Yosky and directed by Frédéric Ozier. More than literal adaptations, the plays address violence, death, crime and fear in contemporary contexts, while revisiting many tropes of the original Grand Guignol corpus, often with humor. Recently formed London-based Grand Guignol company Theatre of the Damned brought their 1st production to the Camden Fringe in 2010 and produced the award-nominated Grand Guignol in November of that year. In 2011, they staged Revenge of the Grand Guignol at the Courtyard Theatre, London, as part of the London Horror Festival. Also based in London, Le Nouveau Guignol formed the UK's only permanent repertory Grand Guignol company. Plays within their current repertoire include French Guignol classics such as The Final Kiss, Tix, or Doing the Deed, The Lighthouse Keepers, Private Room No. 6 and The Kiss of Blood. However, as their company remit also includes encouraging new writing, they have also staged several new plays in the Grand Guignol style, including Eating for Two, Penalty in Ways and Means. Le Nouveau Guignol took part in the London Horror Festival alongside Theatre of the Damned at Courtyard Theatre in November 2011. The Grand Guignolers in Los Angeles, California, established in 2007, create and perform traditional Grand Guignol and original works as a 1920s Parisian theater troupe. Shows are staged as event and draw on multiple forms of traditional physical theatrical genres in new ways, including commedia dell'arte, melodrama, mime, mask, clown, dance, vaudeville, magic, and puppetry. Many shows play with the literal big puppet theme, utilizing puppetry at various levels, including the Petit Guignolers, a French existentially lewd finger puppet show with Grand Guignol effects. The company paid homage to its namesake by staging a surprise 200th birthday party for Guignol with a Grand Guignol children's show, Not for Children. In addition to evenings of classic Grand Guignol, original productions have included A Very Grand Guignol Christmas and Absinthe, Opium, and Magic, 1920s Shanghai. In August to October 2013, the Zarigos Performing Company presented Danse Macabre, a contemporary tribute to Grand Guignol at Theatre for the New City in New York City. Danse Macabre was a program of 4 plays of psychological and physical terror, 1 humorous work and a dance, in keeping with Grand Guignol's programming history. The run ended October 27 at the Bronx Museum of the Arts. The playwrights were Dave DeChristopher, Jack Feldstein, Dylan Guy, Pamela Scott, and Joel Trinidad. Choreographer and director, Sheila Zarigos. In November 2014, 86 years after the last show of Alfredo Zainotti's La Compagnia del Gran Guignol, founded in 1908 and which had been the only example of Gran Guignol in Italy, the Convivio d'Art Company presented in Milan Gran Guignol de Milan, La Caparete Vampires. The show was an original tribute to Gran Guignol, a horror vaudeville with various horror and grotesque performances such as monologues, live music and burlesque, with a satirical black humor conduction. While the original Gran Guignol attempted to present naturalistic horror, the performances would seem melodramatic and heightened to today's audience. For this reason, the term is often applied to films and plays of a stylized nature with heightened acting, melodrama and theatrical effects such as Sleepy Hollow, Quills, and the Hammer horror films that went before them. Whatever happened to Baby Jane? Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte, whatever happened to Aunt Alice? What's the matter with Helen? Night Watch and Whoever Slew Auntie Rue? Form a sub-branch of the genre called Grand Dame Guignol for its use of aging A-list actresses in sensational horror films. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.